Hi, Jose. The topic for today is a bit more personal and totally focused on you. I would like to talk about your personal values and your work ethic. So thank you very much for joining the Employee Story of the Month series. And can you introduce yourself in a few words, please?
Yeah, of course. I'm Jose Manuel Alvarez. I've been working here in Home Lake for the last 3 years. So happy to work here to help my colleagues, to help also the market to grow. And yeah, I'm the B2B manager for the Spanish markets, trying to proceed with all the meetings with my clients, try to analyze the needs that we have as a market, also to help the rest of the team with the small projects. And yeah, in general, I used to manage projects every day to help the B2B department and also to help the company to grow. But yeah, it was almost 3 years. So yeah, working hard for the future.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Thank you. 3 years. I haven't realized it was that long already. Nice.
Yeah, and with COVID in the middle. So I think it comes double.
True. All right. So I think a good place to start is from the very beginning. So what was your dream job as a kid and why?
Oof. I don't know. I think that actually a lot of people say, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a football player, I want to be an astronaut. For me, it was so simple because since I was a kid, I think that for me, the most important thing is to be surrounded by people, to work as a team. So for me, no matters what work, but for me, the most important thing is maintain personal relationship with my colleagues, also with some clients, be part of an international team. It was my dream, actually. The dream that I have, it was to be part of an international company outside of my comfort zone in Spain. But yeah, I think now I get what I wanted in the past. But yeah, I think that I'm still young and we can do a lot of things. I hope that Home Lake together, but yeah, not astronauts and not football player, but happy to keep the personal relation with clients and also with my colleagues.
Mm-hmm. Sounds good. Yeah, I can imagine like a six-year-old Jose, like wanting to build, you know, relationships with clients and work in team.
No, not with clients, but yeah, I'm also happy to be with people, with my friends, with my family. So I couldn't imagine myself like working alone, maybe as a developer or business analyst, something like that. I prefer to be with people to maintain good relation with all the people around me. And if we can create a common project and having a common goal, everything is perfect for me.
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah, I really like that. So now let's talk about your current role. What is the greatest risk you've taken as a professional?
I think the greatest risk before studying, I think that coming here to Germany was a really, really huge challenge for me because I was imagining myself like living in Spain, like trying to, I don't know, maybe in other cities, but definitely Germany was a big challenge because of the culture, because of the language, also because of different people. And yeah, I think that it was a really big challenge. So at the beginning, I was a little bit nervous with other cultures, with other people, but I'm super open. So I'm so happy to meet new friends and the new employees, like trying to have new onboardings every month. But yeah, I think that it was the main risk for me to change completely my routine, to change completely my habits that I had used to have in the past. And I will say the second risk, it was COVID. COVID, I think that definitely it has a huge impact in everyone. Yeah. For me, it was difficult because I was so far from my house, so far from my comfort zone. So I had to prepare myself, also be realistic and try to adapt myself to the new situation. But yeah, in general, I think that everyone used to have like different risk, not only in the personal career, in professional, also in the personal. So yeah, I think that everyone should be able to manage new challenges, new problems, and in general, be adaptable to new changes.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. So going out of a comfort zone and also going into a new environment, this all makes me think about the next question. How do you manage self-doubt?
I think it's really important to manage self-doubt, to manage your feelings, and to manage everything that is happening around you, because doubt is something natural and we need to live with it every day, every year, during our whole life. So for me, the first thing that I used to do is like be positive about everything, the good things and also the bad things. Because if we are able to manage the difficult situations and also to manage how we react to these difficult situations, everything is gonna be better. But if we do it with positivism, if we are negative about everything, we are out of control. So I think that the positivism is the first step, and also try to analyze myself. I think it's really important to see what is happening, which colleagues, for example, can help you, or maybe your family or your partner is important, and also be also orientated to a solution. If we are complaining and being negative, there is like a negativity cycle, so it's horrible. But yeah, for me, I think the first thing is positivism, the next analyze what is happening and how I can control it, and then try to find a solution.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's amazing. I really like your approaches. Couldn't agree more. But what energizes you about work then? How do you motivate yourself and how do you stay motivated?
In the beginning of the call, we were talking about the people, how people is important for me, but also another topic that motivates me every day is learning. I think we need to believe in the long-term learning, because if we learn only one thing in our lives, it doesn't worth it, no? So for me, learn every day, try to get new challenges, try to be out of the comfort zone, try to find new things to learn in general is good. For me, for example, I try to set like new challenges every week or every month, so I can keep myself out of the comfort zone, and it helps me to grow in general.
Yeah, you keep yourself busy and don't
you
don't let yourself get bored or demotivated.
No, not for me. This is not for me.
Nice. So passion and work commitment is quite important, but I think it's also essential to remember how to unplug from work and get your deserved rest in the end of the day. So in remote setup, I think it can get challenging. So is that the case for you? How do you normally unplug from work?
It's essential in every life, especially for me. I want to keep myself super busy when we talk about personal and professional things, but you cannot stay the whole day thinking about work. You also have some friends, you also have some family to look for. And I think for me personally, I love sports, not in the winter, and in Germany it's super difficult outside, but yeah, sport, I used to read, or I try to read every day a little bit, is one of my habits, and also meeting friends. As I told you, like meeting friends, try to maintain good relationships in my personal life, also talk with my family. And now that I'm living here in Germany, is for me is super important also to maintain the relation with old friends, with my family. Do a little bit of sports, reading, I don't know, dancing in the weekends. Yeah, it depends.
Cool. Yeah, I think definitely it's important to have something to have as a hobby or something to just unplug from work and really have this balance. Yeah,
totally. I think you have to be ambitious in your work, but also be natural and try to be a person out of the work, and maintain relationships with the people, find like small places to, I don't know, to go for a beer or to have a good conversation, reading, also be able to maintain the comfort with yourself. Time is also really important. And if you can be healthy and do a little bit of sports every day, is good.
Yeah, for sure. That's why we allow ourselves sometimes at work, once in a while, after the demo day, to also get some drinks and enjoy the company of our colleagues, even though it's in kind of work environment, but still like unplugging from work sometimes is also nice.
Totally. It's really important.
Yeah. All right. Jose, I appreciate all your open answers. Thank you for taking the time to discuss your personal values, your work ethics with me and everyone who is going to see this video. So thank you very much.
Thank you. And also thank you for the initiative. I think it's really good to have this kind of informal chat with every employee, so everyone can know more about the company, about Homebank in general. And thanks Valeria for your time. And I hope you can have a nice week.
Yes, you too. Take care then.